H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
Welcome to another session of H2K Infosys Core Java videos. In this particular session, we'll see a particular stuff about global variables and reference variables of the objects, in which I will basically try to swap the values of the global variables and swap the values of the reference variables pinpointing to the object and see what is the kind of result that I get. This is a very important topic because certain people get confused that if they change the value of the global variable, it will change the value of the reference variable pinpointing to the object. So I'm calling this topic as call by reference and call by value. Call by value is nothing but you're calling the values of the global variables after swapping, and call by reference means you are actually calling the values of the reference variables pinpointing to the object after swapping. So we'll directly see the example, the practical example of it, and we'll see the swapping of the global variables and the swapping of the reference variable and see how does it react. So I'll directly go to the Eclipse IDE, and in this particular session I'm going to create the project as project number, that is session number 23. Click on finish and click the no button. So in this particular project, I will create a package called as, call the package as swapping package. And inside this package, I'm going to create a class called as the swap class, for example. Call the main method. Now I'm going to define two different global variables out here. Rather, the variables will be integer x and integer y. They are non-static global variables, if you can see that. And I'm using the non-static default global variables. So default global variables are the do not have any keywords. So default access specifier does not have any keyword. So I'll stick to it. And the reason for me calling it as a non-static global variable lies in the fact that if I want to call it inside the main method, I need to basically create the object of this particular class. And then only I can reference these global variables with the reference variable of the object created in the main method. So in the main method, what I'm going to do is that I'm going to call these global variables which are non-static. So for that, I need to create the object. So this is the object. I created the object of this particular class called swap, and reference variable S is the reference variable pinpointing to the object, that is new swap. And after that, I'm going to call the global variable which are static, that is x and y. So if we want to call it, then I have to call it with the reference variable s of the object, s dot x, and I will put the value of it in integer format. Let's say the value is 100, and I'll use a CISO statement. After some time, let me define also the value of s dot y. Y is also the global variable which is in non-static in nature, and the value of this is 200, for example. And then I use a CISO statement and call the value of h dot x directly, concatenate with a dash, and the dash is given basically to differentiate or separate the value of s dot x and s dot y. Concatenate this with s dot y. So if I run this particular class file. After saving, I'll get the value of s.x and s.y, and that is will be equal to 100 and 200. And that's what is required. Now, let us swap the value of the global variable, that is x and y, and see that if I swap the value of global variable, it swaps the value of the reference variables or not. Okay, so let us see that. In fact, the global variables are called inside the main method by the reference variable of the object only. So let us look at this particular thing. So if I basically change the values, is it swapping the values of the reference variables or not? So I will call, I'll create a public static method so that I can call it directly inside the main method, which is static, with a void return type. I'll call this as swap by value. That is the function name, and I'll pass on two parameters. I'll call these parameters as integer a and integer y, integer b, for example. Okay, and I'm going to swap the values of these parameters. Okay, now let me put the value of a. So a will have certain value. I've not initialized the value. I will just define an integer temp. Now the integer temp is given the value of a, that is this particular a, the parameter variable a. So that means integer temp has been given the value of the parameter variable a, and now a is empty. So I'll put the value of this b inside a. So I'll call a an equal to b. So what will happen? The value of a has been put to a variable called temp. The variable a becomes empty. So I'm putting the value of b inside a, this value of b. Okay. Now b becomes empty. So what I will do is that I'll put the value of temp inside b. And I have to define like this and put a terminator sign. This is what swapping will do. And then I'm going to do what? I'm going to call this swap value function inside the main method. Now when I basically pass on the values of integer a and integer b, I will not pass on the actual values. I'll pass on this s.x and s.y. Okay, so let down calling the method, and what is the method name? Swap by value. So control c and control v, and then what I do, control spacebar, I can directly call swap by value, and the parameter value of integer will be x.x, s.x. Okay, and the parameter value of integer b is s.y. That means I'm calling the reference variables, and this is the value of reference variable. So these values have been put out here. Okay, so it will actually, so what I'm doing, actually what I'm doing is that I'm putting the value of s.x into integer a, and I'm putting the value of s.y, that is this much, into integer b. And these parameter variables are nothing but simple local variables of the method called swap by value. So that is what has been done. So the integer a will have the value of 100, because integer a is represented by s.x, and integer b will have the value of 200, because integer b is a local variable of this particular method and it has been defined by s.y. Now after that, let's get a CISO statement. So I will put the value of s.x. I want to get the value of s.x. concatenate with the dashes, and then concatenate with s.y. Now if you look at this particular scenario, the value of s.x is 100, the value of s.y is 200. Now you have put these values to a local variable, that is a and b, which is nothing but parameter types for the swap by value method. So what is going to happen? The swapping that is going to happen, so what will happen? The value of s.x will be 200 and the value of s.y will be 100. Why this swapping will happen? because the value of s.x is put to integer a, so becomes, what does value of a hold? A will hold the 100 value, and integer b will hold the value of s.y, that is 200. So a will be empty and the value of 100 will be put to temp, and the value of b, that is s.y, which is nothing but the value of b, that is equal to 200, will be put to b, and b's value, that is 200, will be put to variable a. So a will hold the value of 200 right now, and temp, which is holding the value of 100, will be put to variable b. So actually swapping is going to happen, please understand that, but the swapping does not happen of the reference variable, the swapping happens of these variables. Let us understand that very clearly, because you are referring integer a by s.x whose value is 100. That means integer a value has been swapped to 200 after this particular method is implemented. Similarly, integer b's value was 200, which is nothing but s.y. Now after swapping, the value of integer b will become 100, and that is what I get when I basically call s.x and s.y. So I can just write down one more thing. Swap by value. This is the variable name that is being used. I'll put it within your string format. And then when I run the class file after saving, the value has been swapped or not, you can see that. As the value swapped, the value still remains same. The value of s.x was 100, which was put to integer a. And the value of s.y was 200, which was put to integer b. Now, has the value been swapped? It has not been swapped. It still remains 100 and 200. That means it is not swapping actually the value of the reference variable. It is actually swapping the values of a and b. And how do I know that? I just reference, I call this method again. Okay. So instead of putting s.x, what I will do, I'll put the value of, let's say, 1000 and 2000. And let's say it gets swapped or not. After this, so I don't need a printout for this. Let's get it getting swapped or not. So the 1000 value is for integer A and 2000 value is for integer B. So if it is getting swapped, means it is changing the value of the local variables. Okay, so what is happening out here is that I'm not getting the value of swap by value, this 1000 and 2000, because there's no println command out here. So what I need to do is that I'll put the println command out here. SYSOUT, and just put down the value of A, concatenate with the dashes, and this with your B. So this will be called whenever this is called. Okay, so I will first of all comment this, and then check if the swapping of values for these local variables happens or not. So you see swapping of the values have happened. The value was integer A was 1000 and value of integer B was 2000. After swapping, it is swapping the values. The value of A has become 2000 and B has become 1000. So swapping of the local variable values is happening. But if I comment this and comment this particular code, these two, okay, and why I'm commenting this and this commenting this particular code, because the SISO statement is already present for this swap by value method. So I'll uncomment this and uncomment this. So I'm referring s.x by integer a and s.y by integer b. The value of s.x is 100 and this is 200. So after the swap value by value method is implemented on this particular scenario, is it swapping the value of s dot x to 200 and s dot y to 100 or not? It is not doing it. You can see that it remains at 100 and 200. That means if I am referring the local variable with the global variable and the local variable integer b with the global variable, and I think it will swap the value of the reference variables, it does not happen. It remains same. The value of s dot x remains same at 100 after swapping, and s dot y remains same up to 200 after swapping also, and that is what we see out here. But if I want to see actually this particular program or this particular function is working, then I need to basically comment these two lines of code. Sorry, this is system, and I need to comment these two lines of code, uncomment this swap by value method again, and put the values of integer a as 100, that is I'm passing the parameter value, and b as 2000, and then I can use the SISO statement out here and remove it, and then run the class file again. I'll see the swap has happened. That means it is swapping the value of the local variables, but it is not swapping the values of the reference variables. Okay, so I'll again comment it and comment this part and uncomment it for your reference. Okay, now how do you basically swap the values of the reference variables? So for that, I will create one more function called as public static. I'll call this function with the void return type. I'll call this function as swap. By reference, that means I am trying to swap the value of the reference variable, and this is the method body. And what I am going to pass inside the argument of the swap by reference method, I'll pass on the argument which is the object of this particular class. Okay, so I can just pass the object of this particular class, and what I'm going to pass, not the object, the reference variable of this particular class. So let's say the reference variable of this particular class is s. So I will swap s. So this is what I am passing in the argument. Now I am putting swap because this is the class file name, and this is the reference variable of this class file. Now, so what is going to happen? Now I am going to basically define a integer temp, where I'll put the value of s dot, s is nothing but this particular s, s dot, let's say, s dot a. We can put a, okay. And that s dot a is nothing but s dot x, for example. So I'm calling this global variable x out here. Okay, I'm putting it to a temp. That means s dot x becomes empty. Okay, after that, putting the value of s dot x y into s dot x. So x dot x becomes empty, s dot x equal to s dot y. I'm calling the global variable y. So putting the value of this into this, as this becomes empty, so what I will do, I'll put s dot y equal to temp. That's all. And let me call this particular method, that is calling the method swap by value. Swap by reference. Okay. Now, control spacebar, you will get that particular method. And what I'm going to pass, I'm going to pass, let's say, this, let's say, I can pass Q also. And this Q is nothing but, this Q becomes the reference variable of the swap object, because it is pinpointing to swap s. So q becomes swap s. Simple thing. That means this q is the reference variable of this particular object passed on into inside this swap by reference argument. And after that, if I put a I'll pass on S, the same S out here. Okay. After that, I use a sys out statement, sys out, and I then put S dot X. Concatenate with this dash, and then plus S dot Y. Let us see it is swapping or not. So what is going to happen? S dot X is 100, S dot Y is 200. So this has been, the 100 is put to temp, 200 is put to s dot x, the value of 100 has been put to s dot y, because the value of s dot x is 100 and s dot y is 200. So after swapping, it should become s dot x should become 200 and this should become 100. Let's see that swap happens or not. So save the class file after running. So 200 and 100, you see it is coming. This 100 and 200 is coming for this println command, which is the earlier value, and this swap by value 100 and 200, it is not getting changed. This is coming for this println command used in swap by value method, and actually this is where it is swapping the values of the reference variable. So 100 becomes 200 and 200 becomes 100. So you see that if we change the value of the variable, local variables, it does not mean you are changing the value of the reference variables of the object or the reference variable pinpointing to the object. So let's be careful about that. Okay, that's about it. If you have any questions, please revert to us. Thanks very much.